you're going to insist that the Muslim woman can only work in hijab, she can only work in burqa, it might significantly alter her employability.
Sure,
employers will, supposing I as a Hindu woman came in full Hindu, you know, gear with the 9-yard sari and a nathni and, you know, whatever, it may again impede my employability because employers are looking for professionals who are dressed for the job. Now, aren't you adding to the burden of the woman who, as it is, can't get a job, as it is, being a Muslim is a problem. Now you're saying on top of that you have to wear a burqa to get
in,
a job.
Post 9/11, there were fatwas issued that Muslim women, because they were being persecuted and harassed, that they should really, it was all right if they took off the veil because of persecution.
Yeah.
So there are times change, and there are,
it's not,
you know, I'm just saying, why
rules
change, ruling change according to environment.
Why isn't there then an introspection, as you're saying?
There's a lot of flexibility.
Yes, for security.
Within Sharia. The Sharia came to preserve, to conserve. It's about good citizenship. It's about really a healthy society, and we have, and about purification of the soul. You know, it is guidance.
Let's get a reaction in from you.
Yes, so much on outwardly.
As far as the extreme circumstances are concerned, yes, it is allowed. But when it is a normal life, when you can have the employment according to your own desire and according to preaching of Islam, what is the problem in it?
Is a problem. Actually, there is a problem. Let's take a break and come back. We're asking the question, are Muslim women victims of identity politics? Carry on with your voting. We'll carry on with our discussion. Athar Hussain Saab, how is a woman expected to find employment if she's in burqa? This is the question you have to ask yourself. Isn't it time that these fatwas and seminaries, you know, looked after the interests of people rather than simply the interests of ideology and doctrine? How is a woman supposed to find employment if she has to be in the burqa?
As far as I am concerned, I don't have a copy of that fatwa as yet, because every fatwa is very specific to the question. You can understand that. But if in general we go that it's a fatwa that no Muslim woman without hijab should work along with men, so my personal opinion is that they should opt for those professions where they can cater to the society's development, and as far as hijab,
again, we're back to this whole thing that
I'm
women.
I'm very surprised because Firangi Mehal has been a very liberal, and very enlightened seminary, issuing some wonderful rulings.
Shazia, you were also saying that you were protesting that it's haram to accept a woman's salary. Yeah. What if there is no man? What if haram to accept
it's
a woman's salary?
It's haram and illegal. This is the wording of the
fatwa. It's haram. It's illegal. That's what they've said. That's what they've said.
Sagarika.
Now, respond to that. Does a woman have to be perpetually dependent on a man's salary?
Absolutely. No, that's what it says.
No. You can put it in another way.
No, it says it's haram or illegal for a woman's salary is considered haram or illegal by the family members. And it's really sad, you know, in this time and age.
Wealth in Islam is discretionary. Her wealth is
a religion,
not responsible.
This is a religion which gave property and inheritance rights to women. Civil infanticide was banned, which was there pre-Islamic age. And now we're talking about a woman's salary being haram and illegal.
So a woman is always dependent on a man to give her money.
Actually, what is happening? Even the good things are being interpreted in a bad manner. What actually
but
is
that's what it says.
No,
that's
no,
exactly
if
the wording of
what, what is the wording? What is the wording? What
it
is, says?
That is that it, it in fact it has decreed it is haram and illegal according to Sharia for a family to accept a woman's earnings.
What it says in fact. Actually the wording says in fact the I do not know who translated and what are the actual original thing. What is the basic idea about the whole thing? If the woman is making and earning a money, she is not liable to spend that money on her family because the Islam wants the women fall to be independent as far as the financial
position
is concerned.
But it's open to interpretation in many
ways.
No, it's
wrong.
It might be interpreted as the fact that a woman's money is not to be taken by the family.
I do not know what actually
is
said.
This was really done in the Protestant tradition to honor women and not to take the responsibility
of the
family.
Yes, in fact, all her earnings, all her earnings are for herself, are for earning for the future. And it is the responsibility of the man. It is the responsibility of the man.
It comes
to look
without
after.
Isn't that the condescending gaze of patriarchy, that the man will look after, the karta dharta will look
yes,
after.
Yes, because it is his responsibility.
No, but why? That's patriarchy.
No, it's not patriarchy.
It's patriarchy. No, if you relegates a woman. No, it's.
I do not know what are you talking. It's not relegatory.
Making her dependent completely on the man, ensuring that she does not have any economic independence whatsoever.
I'm sorry, what you are saying is absolutely
linking,
absurd.
Linking
wrong.
Employability with
you're
the
wrong. In fact, you are taking
it's
too
taking
long.
A choice away.
I think you are taking it too far, Sagarika.
I don't think it's a very pious interpretation of what he's offering of the decree, and I don't see it in
I think it's wrongly phrased.
No, it's a wrongly phrase. I'm telling you, I'm honest about it. I can come back to you if it's that. It's wrong. What? It's not. It's not haram.
It's discretionary. She can do whatever.
But by making a difference, I do not know who has translated it because the fatwa must not have been in English.
I'm 101% sure. These people may not be knowing English at all. They must have given their fatwa in Urdu or Arabic. I'm 101% sure this is wrong.
But by making a distinction between a man's earnings and a woman's earnings, isn't that essentially again creating an imbalance between a man and a woman and saying it's the man that's looking after a woman's earning is for herself or may not be accepted as haram?
Why create that difference? They're citizens, they're both equal people earning. In fact, it is the beauty of Islam which says that all the properties of women, she's not supposed to spend. Nobody should ask her to take care of the family.
The protective devices are becoming prisons.
It's not prison.
The protective devices are becoming prisons. The burqa is supposed to be a protective device to shield the woman from the.
If you feel it is a prison, we are happy to be it.
Yes, it is.
If it is a prison, if you term it as a prison, I can't help it. Because as far as we are concerned, Islam gives the complete protection.
Well,
Islam
gives a double-edged sword.
So who is asking you? You are free to do whatever you feel like. But if you have to be a Muslim woman, you have to follow it.
You in fact pretend to be a benefactor and says, I want to look after you, and you don't step out. It can be interpreted in any which way. But I'm not sure the reasons are that of piety and complete perfect jurisprudence in the way the fatwa is issued.
Unfortunately, we're completely out of time. Kamal Farooqi here saying, if you're a Muslim woman, you have to live according to these tenets.
Absolutely.
The two women on the panel saying that this is a case of misinterpretation of the teachings of the Quran. Thanks very much indeed for joining us. Athar Hussain, Kamal Farooqi, Sadia Zahelmi, Shazia Elmi, thanks very much indeed for joining us with your final verdict. Are women always the victims of this kind of identity assertion? 85% there saying yes.